Being on the margins of history and herstory, as a community, we're often at a deficit. We often face a deficit on institutional memory, on continuity, right? Stonewall and Anita Bryant and Matthew Shepard were not in my history books, and chances are they probably still not in our history books, in our textbooks. Yet, of course, it goes without saying that it's important to know where we've been in order to understand where we are and where we want to go. In that respect, I've been sort of snooping around the archives myself, and delighted and saddened as well to see so many sort of wonderful documents that give us a sense of just how far we've come, and yet how much still remains the same, how much still needs to be done. I just want to show you, for instance, this letter from Harvey Milk to the President Carter in 1978. It's nearly 40 years ago. I don't know if you can read that out loud, but I'll just read it real quickly. On the November 1978 California ballot will be an initiative called the Briggs Initiative, which would prohibit gay persons from teaching and would have other serious infringements on individual rights. Though it is a state ballot issue, it is also of great national importance, and we hope you will strongly oppose it. I would very much appreciate a response to our call for your support, and I would be honored to work with you to protect the human rights of all Americans. Sounds familiar, doesn't it, even today? It sounds eerily familiar with all that's happening, with all these LGBT rights bills that have been sort of trying to be pushed through in the name of religious freedoms. But more, for me, more than just historical data or historical documents, I see these documents as a kind of poetry, in the sense that both put real names, real faces, real lives to issues that can tend to be very abstracted. They memorialize those issues by humanizing them, just like poetry. That is Harvey Milk's signature. His hand was on that paper. And I think that's a very powerful and important thing. These documents do what no newspaper or magazine article or biased historians can do. They show truth in its plain and barest form. They humanize it. They bear witness to what it feels like to live in a certain time, in a particular place, and under specific circumstances, just like poetry in my book.